Beets have all sorts of health benefits: fiber, potassium, folate, metabolites. That last one may not be as familiar as the others, but it's just as important to the functioning of your body. And researchers at Joslin Diabetes Center are probing the possibilities that a particular nutrient metabolite found in beets and other vegetables and grains could reduce insulin resistance. Metabolites are small molecules which can help cells to function or are the byproducts of cellular metabolic processes. The metabolite being studied by Dr. Allison Goldfein and her collaborators is found in high concentration in beets. And levels of this metabolite in the blood of people who have insulin resistance, prediabetes, and cardiovascular risk factors are lower than in healthy people. This association spurred Dr. Mary Elizabeth Patty to see if replacing this nutritional metabolite found in beets would improve health of mice fed a high-fat diet. Her lab showed that levels of the metabolite dropped when rats were fed a high-fat diet. But after the treatment, metabolism in mice improved. These positive outcomes have encouraged Dr. Allison Goldfein and her collaborators to move forward into human trials. Dr. Gonzalez, could you please tell us more about betaine and what the laboratory is working on?
Insulin resistance precedes and predicts type 2 diabetes and is considered a very important risk factor. We performed careful measures of insulin sensitivity in about 40 people with risk for diabetes, but who did not have diabetes, and looked for the metabolites in their blood that were associated with insulin resistance. We found that betaine, a modified amino acid, was strongly associated with insulin resistance. So, in collaboration with Dr. Patty, we looked at how betaine was regulated by high-fat diet in rodents, and if replacement had any effect on the blood sugars of these animals. We were pleased to see that the sugars were lower in rats given betaine in their diets. Betaine is a dietary constituent commonly found in beets and whole grains. It plays several roles in cellular metabolism, and it is currently used as a drug for treatment in patients with a rare metabolic disorder. Also available as an over-the-counter dietary supplement, which makes it safe for human consumption at the doses being studied. We have epidemiologic data that associates low betaine levels with insulin resistance and cardiovascular disease risk in humans. So now, we want to know if we give it to people in a controlled clinical trial, can we improve three measures that we think are the most important? The three outcome measures being studied include whether the oral supplement improves sugar levels and insulin resistance, whether it improves blood vessel function as a marker of cardiovascular risk, and whether it reduces liver fat. We are recruiting overweight individuals with prediabetes or risk factors for diabetes, but not clinical diabetes. So basically, we're looking for people who are overweight, have high blood pressure or high cholesterol levels, or a family member with diabetes, or women with a history of diabetes during pregnancy, or people who are ethnic minorities. Interested participants will be screened for type 2 diabetes before entering the trial.
The trial participation involves two overnight stays in the Clinical Research Center of the Brigham and Women's Hospital at the beginning and at the end of the study to measure insulin resistance, blood vessel function, and liver fat before and after starting treatment. This study is funded by a grant from the American Diabetes Association. If you're interested in learning more about this clinical trial, please contact Dr. Anna Maria Grisales at 617-309-4736 or by email at anna.maria.grisales@joslin.harvard.edu.